Hello students, my name is Anthony sir and today we are going to learn very important topic preposition which is very important for class 8, 7, 8, 9 and 10 as well. So preposition is very large, very huge subject to learn. So I cannot put everything in one video. So I'm going to make different videos. First video is the meaning because you have to understand the meaning of preposition. Second video is the classes of preposition. Third video, position of preposition. And fifth video, use, how to use it in the sentence. And in that fifth video, we will have so many different videos because we have to learn the use also and we have to learn the difference between two prepositions also. And after that, we will make a video of exercise also. Okay, so preposition subject, I cannot cover everything in one video. There will be series of videos and I want you to watch every video to learn preposition because preposition, there are more than 50-60 prepositional words and you need to know the meaning of each one and the use of each one also. Okay, so let's start with the meaning. Okay, but before we start, I would like you to subscribe my channel and also share with your friends so that they can also be helped to learn English grammar freely. Okay, so the meaning. Here you can see on the screen the meaning is given here. So let's try to understand. I read the meaning. A preposition is a word placed before a noun, pronoun or gerund. Okay, gerund is also a kind of noun. It is the verb, but in the sentence it works as noun. That is why it can be put after preposition also. So preposition is a word that is normally put before noun, pronoun or gerund. It denotes the relation of the person or the thing with something else. Now this is very important to understand. So the work of preposition is to show the relation between the first noun, that is our subject, and the second noun, that is our object. So okay, so it is used in between subject and object. So the word itself, the prepositional word itself shows the relation. What is the relation between the subject and the object? Okay, so that is why it is very important to learn where to put it. And I will make one video of the position of preposition. So what is the meaning? Number one, it is preposition. Pre means before. Okay, so preposition, placed before noun, pronoun or gerund, and it shows the relation between the subject and the predicate, subject with the other words. Okay, now let's see in the example. The food is on the table. Now the food is subject. Okay, the table is the object of the sentence. Now the relation between the food, the table. Now let me tell you one thing. Imagine this sentence without preposition, and here the preposition word is on. The food is the table. Does it make sense? No, it doesn't make sense because we need a word that shows the relation between the food and the table. And here the prepositional word, appropriate prepositional word is on. If we put any other prepositional word, then also the meaning will change or you will not get the right meaning. Okay, so the appropriate preposition is on. The food is on the table. On preposition, table is noun, pronoun. Okay, so this is how it is used, and the word on is shows the relation between the food and the table. Second example is also given here. I am fond of chocolate. Okay, so I is the subject here and chocolate is the object, is the other part of the sentence, predicate. So the relation between I and the chocolate is shown by the word preposition of. Okay, if you don't put of, listen, the sentence will be I am fond of chocolate. I am fond chocolate. Doesn't make any sense because we need a word that shows the relation between I and the chocolate, and that is why the appropriate preposition in this sentence is of. Okay, now let's go some extra information in the definition. As given in the example above, a word such as noun, pronoun or gerund following a preposition is said to be the object of the preposition. So the word after the preposition word, it is called the object of the preposition. So in this first sentence, table is the object. Second sentence, chocolate is the object. It is always in the objective case. Okay. So you will find this preposition in the objective case. Good. Next, a preposition is always followed by a noun and never by a verb. Okay. After preposition, we can never use the verb. We must always use what? Noun or pronoun. Then if we want a verb to follow a preposition, if you want to use the verb after preposition, then what we should do? We must use the ing form or that of that particular verb. Okay. So when we want to use the verb, we have to put the ing form. And because we put the ing form, it will become what? Which should be gerund. It will become gerund in the sentence. And gerund is also kind of noun. It works as noun in the sentence. So these are the rules for preposition. Okay. So I want you to learn this video. I want you to watch this video again and again and try to understand first what is preposition, the word, the meaning. Okay. It is part of the sentence. It is a word and it is part of the sentence, but you need to know the meaning and you need to know the work of preposition, the work of preposition to show relation between noun pronoun, the subject and the noun pronoun in the object. Okay, good. So I hope you have understood the meaning, and in our next video we will learn the classes of preposition. Okay. Thank you so much. Bye bye.